First thing I'd say is VCU played a heck of a game. Excuse me, you gotta give a lot of credit to them. Not sure what Gilmore's numbers were going into the game. I think it was maybe like 3 for 16 from three. And I think Sims hit that other three in that thing, and I think he's been struggling a little bit. And those are good players, and that's what good players do. But, you know, that was, I thought we really battled. And I think it was tie game at that point. And he had three threes and went on a run. And, you know, we could just never recover. You know, I think our front court played really, really well tonight. I think Greg and Jared, tag team, you know, both in double figures. Jordan really gave us a really good effort, you know, and some guys who've been phenomenal for us every game. You know, we just struggled a little bit tonight, and sometimes that happens. So I told our guys, you know, we had as good a practice as I've ever had as a coach last night. And we got a group of guys who are working their rear end off every single day in practice. And at the end of the day, that's all you can ask for. We played a really good team tonight who played at a high level, made big shots when it counted. We'll live to fight another day. And the biggest thing we told our guys is, you know, you can't let VCU cost you two in a row. In other words, we can't have a hangover from this. We don't have time to wallow. We got to get ready for, a good Richmond team. That's really starting to find its own legs and be able to bounce back with a good effort on Wednesday.
Hey, when you look at their defense and what they kind of bring, you know what's coming, obviously. But how hard is it for guys to get ready for something like that?
Yeah, it is hard. You know, and one of the unfortunate things, and again, all 100% of credit goes to VCU. Jamal Hartwell sprained his knee yesterday in practice here. You know, he's been, I think, I don't know what his assistant turnover ratio is, like, ridiculously high. And if there's ever a game that you want him, your backup point guard, this is one. You know, those things happen. Because there was a stretch there, you know, I don't know in my 4 years of coaching if I've ever seen Otis Livingston absolutely gassed. And he was gassed. You know, he was gassed tonight. It's hard to replicate it. I thought we did a good job. And then, you know, as they will do, flurry of turnovers. I think more than anything, they wore us down in the half court. I think what's maybe underrated, or I don't know, I'm not here every day, but like, you know, their half court defensively, that's an outstanding, complete defensive group, you know, in the full court and the half court.
Jared, when you know you guys erased that 14-point hole and tied, and they hit three after three. Just how deflating was that for you guys?
Yeah, it's a bit deflating. I mean, to put all that energy out to get back to a tie, and they hit a few threes, but at the end of the day, we made mistakes that gave them three, so that's on us, and you can't let that happen.
Coach, you mentioned just having that half court D is. What are the differences you've seen from last year? This year, it's a lot of the same guys, but you know, instead of Justin Tillman, who's an all-conference player, they got two sophomores in there. So what's the difference?
They're a pretty good defensive team too last year. You know, obviously the numbers. I mean, you guys have all looked at the numbers and the media notes. You know, so you know they're just doing a better job of challenging at the three-point line. So their three-point field goal defense is really, really good. So, you know, I would guess probably Mike would say, you know, it takes a second year, you know, for guys to really understand that next rotation, that next effort that allows them to put full court pressure on and still be, you know, really solid in the half court.
You need to be able to wear players down. What did you kind of take out of the approach specifically with Justin and Otis, throughout the game?
I'm sorry, what was that?
Oh, you mentioned kind of wearing guys down. What did you kind of take out of the approach specifically with Justin and Otis, eliminating them throughout the game today defensively?
Yeah, they did, and then it didn't help that Justin got foul trouble, you know, and again, like the one last guy, you know, who probably, Hartwell probably averages 8 or 9 minutes a game, but this would have been a game you probably would have paid 10 or 12 or 14. So, Yeah, it warmed down, and they missed some shots that we've seen them make, you know, quite a bit. So all that stuff is cumulative. You know, there's a good team. It's a tough place to win on the road. You know, our group has been phenomenal in terms of their approach and their practice. And, you know, the last game that we had like this where, you know, was our Vermont game, you know, maybe, I don't know, December 1st. And we really went on a quest to improve and get better. That's what we have to do. You know, that there's a lot of basketball left to be played. We're at the halfway point. And, you know, we just got to try to get, you know, marching better every night out.
Hey, along those lines, at the midpoint, do you feel like you put yourself in a pretty good spot in the league, or do you feel like you're trending the right way?
Yeah, I mean, obviously we're down about tonight's result, but if you look at it, you know, with some perspective, you know, if you had told me whatever, December 1st, that you're going to be 7-2 at the turn, you know, I'd have signed up for it. And more than that, in all seriousness, you know, we can't control. We probably get another 2-for-19 night ahead of us, shooting for three. You know, we probably got a couple 12-for-19 nights like that. That's the nature of the beast. But the way that this group has approached practice and the way that this group has attacked trying to get better has been a ton of fun to be around. I told them there's no group of guys I'd rather be coaching. So at the end of the day, that's all we can do. Sometimes the ball goes in, sometimes it doesn't. We learn how to handle success and deal with some adversity.
Coach, was there any reason why y'all really stopped feeding the post after y'all tied it at 52?
Yeah, I mean, I think fatigue and ball pressure and yeah, you know, I mean, that's what happens, you know, some poor decisions. And then we got it in there a couple times and the ball rolled around and out. And, you know, so I think just a variety of things. So, you know, we'll go back and look at the film and there's a lot to improve upon, but there's a lot to build from.
And Al?
Can we get a status on AJ?
Yeah, I mean, he's healthy. You know, he couldn't play too much better than Jared and Greg played tonight, so.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.